Welcome to Data Warehouse Concepts and Implementation Introduction video. This is the first video in this playlist where I'm going to cover the Data Warehouse concepts and I'm going to implement using some examples. Let us try to understand what are the topics I'm going to cover in my next slide. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in Data Warehouse. So I'm going to cover the architecture and dimension modeling, data maths, staging, ODS, different types of facts and dimensions, slowly changing dimensions. So basically these contributes to the core concepts behind the data warehouse, and nevertheless some key components like surrogate keys, column store index, handling inferred members. So these are some of the things that will come along when we implement data warehouse, and which are very important when you have to handle certain scenarios in data warehouse. So at last we see like incremental load, how you incrementally load the data without removing the existing record or fact, and you will extract only the whatever changes happen. That is also I'm going to cover. So I'm not going to explain only the concepts. I will explain the concepts. Along with that, I'm going to implement it. So is there any prerequisite those who want to implement along with me? Yes, obviously. You need to have at least a basic understanding about SSIS and SQL in order to practice or implement it. So why this is required? Let us try to check in my next slide. This is a typical architecture of BI, and data warehouse resides here, and I'm not going to explain much about it. What I can say is like the data warehouse you will develop, and this will be residing in the database. So in order to access or create objects and query it from the data warehouse, you need to know SQL. So that is why SQL is important, and you need to bring the data from different sources into staging or data warehouse layer using a tool called SSIS, SQL Server Integration Service. So these two concepts or tools are prerequisite in order to implement your data warehouse. So this is the reason why I said SQL and SSIS are required. If you are not learned, or if you don't know about SQL and SSIS, no need to worry. I have given a description below in this video. I have a separate playlist for SSIS and SQL. You can go through it, and once you are familiar with, you have basic understanding about it, then you can implement data warehouse as well. With this note, we'll stop here and let us look into data warehouse architecture in my next video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.